there, everyone. Eizen the Broniac here, and welcome back to the Final Fantasy V Forge of Fiesta run. As you can all that tell, when we last went to this game, I finally cleared out the fire crystal and got my well-needed, well-deserved red mage. So now, she can cast white magic and black magic spells! Huzzah! But anyway, we are now at the Library of the Ancients, so we can go rescue Mid, and quotation marks, since he really doesn't need it. But now we take on Byblos. And normally, this would be a difficult boss fight. Not if I have fire by my side. So let us cast Fire on Byblos. Because he is actually weak to only fire, and I have been turned into a tank. Not a problem. I have plenty of maiden's kisses. Here we go. Fuse! How dare you confuse my party member? No, I'm not gonna do that. Because my hope is that you'll accidentally think about attacking me. No, I'm not gonna change my strategy for this. Drain! Drain! Ah, damn it, it's protecting us. Ah! Son of a. Raise Galoof. We need him back in our game. And why would you stop slowing him down? Okay, I didn't want him to come to this, but left me no choice, Ferris. Stop attacking my party! And I finally killed Byblos. And he just gets a standard fate. So yeah, after all that, please, Lena, heal my party members because they could really use the spells. And that's be it. Since right away we're given a passage. I almost feel tempted to say this is slightly better than the Game Boy Advance mugshot. I'm only going by slightly. Probably because I don't like the whole, villager, apparel he's got from, Animal Crossing. I think if you got rid of the whole Animal Crossing nose and just made it the same skin color and texture of everyone else's nose, I wouldn't mind it that much. But, whatever. So now we have to go backtrack. No, we don't. Mid knows the secret passageway. And probably a good thing, too, because that leads us directly to the same room where we can go get our recovery pot. And yes, even though Mid did not notice it... My god, he looks really short compared to everyone. I just noticed that. What, is he like a baby compared to everyone else? Jesus Christ, I can't believe I did not notice it up until now. So awesome, he made crap that blows up. I'm just wondering if I should give him, like, baby talk, or, like, a child speech for whenever Mid talks. Since he's that short, I mean, honestly, I kind of pictured him as a young adult. That's not even a young teenager, by the looks of it. And, no, don't you dare go back up. I will get my damn recovery and like it. But, oh, damn, I just realized I can't go back in there. Oh, wait. No, I still can. What am I talking about? Because there's actually one more enemy I do want to show off. Which I'm surprised it didn't show up here. Is this room good enough to show it off in? Please tell me this room is good enough to show it in. Please tell me this room is good enough to show it in? Damn it. You know what I just realized? It's probably because I killed Byblos that he's not going to do anything. Well, damn it. We missed out on one enemy, which was the Moon Flute Berserker enemy, but whatever. I'm sure if you look at someone else's run, like maybe Kyrix has it. His run. I think he mentioned something about finally making it to the desert, going against sandworm last I checked. And I just realized you're still attacking Ferris. And we see what old looks like, which is can't really tell by his animal hood that he's wearing, but apparently, it makes you look, white. Like, pale white. From the looks of it. So yeah, after all that mess we went through just to, go through that, we now have to go up again, go back up to Karnak in order to convince, Sid not to be so mopey-dopey. And turn that frown upside down. And right when we're about ready to enter town. I'll give you credit for one thing. You do know how to push my buttons when necessary. Anyway, now that we are back here, let's just head back into the pub, where somehow, we managed to outrun Mid. But then again, Mid's a child, so, that's a given. And Sid still looks down at the dumps. And here comes Mid. Grandpa! Yeah, look how small he is! Look like he's doing a cha-cha or something like that. What am I doing? What are you doing, you silly old fool? You never give up. Never, never, never. Good lord. Oh. Yeah, he is a child. He is quite literally a child. Of course I am! And I'm slowly making him turn back into Ridley. No, there could be room for only one Ridley, and that's Syldra. Anyway, I'm probably getting this surprise. Never mind. Get back to work on the fire ship, if you will, please. There you go. Seriously, look at the size of it! Compared to Sid, Mid is a freaking child. And no, I'm never gonna let that go. In case you're wondering, I will never let that go. I just can't. Except to go to the fire ship, and it's automated. Oh my guys, we're trying to get to work here. automatic, go to the private room here. It's a shame it doesn't have any beds to sleep in there. I think the airship, once we get it, they have it locked in there. Yeah, almost remember. Not to mention, it seems like Ferris almost has blonde hair. And all of a sudden, I'm slow. Oops. Okay, now we see Krill. And that picture I love of Krill, that is actually a step up from the GBA portrait. Okay, legitimately, you got a positive out of me, game. Take it for what it's worth. I might never say something like that again. And I was gonna say, even though Mid is a blonde, thanks to this sepia tone look, it makes him look like he's got gray hair. Because, you know, it instantly makes me think about, can't remember who those characters were. And I can understand why. Yeah, I'm just gonna bop you in the head, you silly old fool. Bop, 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 bop. oh, man. I am already starting to lose track of where I'm going. With the gray-haired short person and the tall, white hair person. It made me think about those set of characters from Seinfeld, like the Mandible family. Because I think it's like the middle child who is apparently old, but not the oldest. He's just older. He's apparently it's like can't remember what's his face. He was the actor who was in Airplane and Mafia. You know who I'm talking about. You know, I picked the wrong week to quit smoking, drinking, amphetamines, and sniffing glue. You know the actor I'm talking about. He was like the middle child. I forgot who the younger one was, who's like maybe a few years younger than him. And then it was the elderly old man, who's like beyond old. And they break their backs easily after saying it's go time and try to lift something up. And then it just reminds me of Kramer's Blood, where they're just doing that chant, mandible, mandible, or manobomb. I don't even... Wait, I'm thinking of the movie Ants with Mandible. Maybe it was Mandibomb. I don't even know anymore. I am getting sidetracked here. Let's just return back to the Final Fantasy V four-job Fiesta run. This is why I should get guest commentators in later parts, because I can't keep this up forever. And even if I can't keep this up forever, you don't want me to get sidetracked. Not in a Final Fantasy V four-job Fiesta run. That's just nonsense. Slept like a top. That doesn't even make any sense. We are so awesome! Yeah, because it's Steam power. Much like the version of the game I'm playing on Steam. So anyway, they head off to Library of the Ancients, almost lost track of what I was saying, but yes. There are actually two places where we can go to. One is a bit of a side trail. The other one is an absolute necessity. So I think I'm going to go the way of the side trail, because why the hell not? So, okay, now we fight people on the sea. Because we're actually at an ocean, not just a sea. I got gotta tell you, for being Thunder and Avalanche, they're actually quite strong durability-wise. And of course, we couldn't have a Final Fantasy game without Sahagins at sea. I mean, that doesn't mean wrong otherwise. And more lightning scrolls. Yeesh. But now we can have easy access to there. I think it's just the south of us. And I don't feel like getting side attacked by back attacked by this group, so thank you. Run away from that. And of course, you can go to the left from there, but until you can tame a sandworm to take a path for you, which is while we're on our way to the first step. Not really necessary at this point, so let's just move on over here. Right there is the next area I'm supposed to be in. There's the cave. Can you... Oh, I have to stop pressing. So there's the cave and some bio soldiers, which I don't have any thieves, but I think they drop axes if I kill them. And there's a reason they call them bio soldiers, for a reason. So they can cast bio on your entire... let's use that much needed cure just to make sure. Yeah, it costs more. Probably more effective off battle in battle. Off battle, probably not by much. Okay, that should be enough for now. Let's just continue on over here. And here we are at Jahol Village. Two main reasons why to go here. Some more items to get here, but of course, as a necessity, the piano. So please, everyone, shut the hell up so we can listen to this. Piano keys are with you, young butts, but you are not a piano master yet. Getting there. You're getting there. And just because we feel like wasting even more time, let's dance with the dancers. Or dancer. And you actually convince that guy from the seats to dance with you. Breaking the fourth wall, are you? No, I don't feel like dancing. And yeah, thankfully, it's just one more time. I'm just glad I'm doing that once, so we never have to do that again. Yeah, give the sick Heil to her. She deserves it. Anything from in here? What's in the item shop? Nothing that I really... that later. Anyway, now that we left the pub area, some more items we can get from there. Anything there? Or here, maybe? Yeah. Give me one quick second, folks. Because I think it's in the caves. There's definitely some. Yeah, something in the cave, but not with the village. So let's just leave it at that and check out what is in this village. So I think, yeah, there's a magic shot there, which we'll check out later. First of all, let's check out armor and defense. And this time I'm actually going to start with defense, like I meant to. I sold that one, didn't I? I think I just sold that one for here. Oh well, now we have another one. A jaunty green cap. Stylish ninja clothing bought from a faraway land. I would certainly hope so. Prevent silence. Yes, I will take a status surplus and one more in the suit. So, let's see. Got the ninja suit. Ray. Status surplus. The only thing I need. Well, actually, I'll get a second one because, you know. Aside and This is the enemy I was talking about. This is the enemy I'm talking about. You have to be extremely powerful in order to kill that enemy. Let's not flip the switch. Okay, let's flip the switch. Thought it would undo everything that was necessary to go there. Stop running into the damn skull eaters, and thank you for blocking that. They are extremely powerful. They are called skull eaters for a reason. I believe there are three treasure chests in here. Oh, thank God, I decided to run away. And I get five bonus job points just for running away. Like, look at that! One hit against him, and he's already down for the count. Ouch! Already I'm starting to run low on MP. So, let's at least once more do that just to keep him well updated. Yeah, Nutkins, I don't mind. They aren't that powerful. Or strong for that matter. Now, here's an interesting fact. There are three treasure chests that you can get in this area. The third one, you'll only get if you remember not to free the pickpocket lone wolf. If you let him go, he takes what is in the third chest. So, what kind of item do you miss out on? The Blitz Whip. Which is, as you imagine, those who remember... Okay, I'll take that. I'll take it. And I remember that cave just leads to a different part of the cave, which is blocked off, so... kind of pointless. So, let's just head over here. And I believe I'm going to sail off to Crescent Town. If I finish it soon enough... I might explore more of the Crescent Town. Otherwise, I'm just gonna leave as it is. Thank goodness I did not get hit by that. And let's head back through here. And hopefully, let's escape from that. Hopefully, it does escape from that. And I'm hearing thunder outside, so, yeah. Kind of a shame I'm only doing four episodes in this session, but I really don't feel like, trying to play through this game just for it to, crash on me and I lose everything from this. Not really that fun to do. Because I actually missed out on getting an item from that area. I'm just going to go over to Crescent Island, and I'll get the other part offline, or the other stuff offline, so I won't have to... Well, actually, once I get there, it's not going to let me go back. So, I'm actually going to just stop it right here anyway. It's a bit of a short part, but... thanks to a thunderstorm that I'm hearing outside, I don't want to risk losing this data. So, with that said, this has been Eizen the Broniac saying I thank you for watching these videos. If you'd like to see more of them, then please feel free to like and subscribe to my channel. And check out more stuff that I have on my Daily Motion channel as well, since I got more Let's Plays on there. Some Eyes and Try videos, and even some blind reactions to My Little Pony-esque videos. So until then, folks, take care, and I shall see you all later.